all said it was an army of Akashi.
Which song should we...
It's a dangerous world.
You'll not find a better price than that. You're robbing me blind, you know.
Finished, are you?
Trouble with your gear, or...
What's that for you, dear?
Anything else?
All right, Clive. My dad had it all worked out.
He'd be proud of you, Mid. His writings may have helped, but this achievement is all yours. Can we catch them?
The Ainayar's one of the largest, fastest vessels ever built. And it won't help she has the wind at her back. Any other ship would be hard-pressed to keep pace with her, let alone reel her in. But this isn't any other ship. This is the Enterprise! And the world's never seen anything like my dad's engine.
It certainly hasn't.
Clive, what do you know of Barnabas Tharm?
Only what the bards sing. And he sailed to Ash from southern lands. That it was his mastery of the blade which won him the throne. And that his sword, Odin's sword, can sever the very threads of creation. But don't lose any sleep over a last tilt. We'll do what we must to survive.
What we must.
The light! I thought this cove was meant to be hidden!
Mid! Company!
Eh?
We'll hold them off until the ship is ready. But hurry!
Bollocks!
All hands! Man your stations!
Everyone with me? Here they come! That was easy enough.
All right, you lousy lot. Get your asses on board. She's ready to sail.
You heard the captain. Clive.
Huh?
Confounded. Then it is as I feared. Sleipnir is no man, but a creation of Odin.
Phoenix's fiery fundament. Have you no normal enemies?
Up for another round?
Of course we are. Right, Lord Rosfield?
My boy, there was a time people called me the Executioner. Who was in my office? No matter, heads will roll all the same.
Mate, new plan! You leave, we follow!
Follow? Swimming, are you? Oh, bugger me! Weigh anchor! Engine's dead slow ahead!
Have care, my friends. 'Tis not blood that runs through an enemy's veins. These foes will not fall.
But they will fall.
Like oaks before a woodman's axe. Good thing I'm Rothbard!
How long are we meant to keep this up?
As long as it takes. Unless you have a better idea.
Well, I've already killed at least 5 of the bastards.
Fuck it! Let's do the lot!
Ah! Ah! Let it out, help!
What do you want?
That's quite a mess you've made. And wholly unnecessary. You are my offering to Muthos. I would not see you damaged.
Now back to your stations! Every bell spent treading water puts another league between us and the galleon.
I don't suppose Mid has a spare engine. Since you rose from the grave, my fortunes have plummeted. Are you absolutely certain of this quest of yours, Clive? The foes you face are as terrible as they are numerous.
Aye, and they'd have us live and die on their terms, which should answer your question.
You have that same stubborn look as your father did when he set his mind to something. On the battlefield, I am but a single axe. A deadly one, mind, but a single one nonetheless. Yet what you require is 1,000, and I believe my old friend in Brandalar can provide them. Take care, Clive. I have many more tales of your father's exploits to share. And I cannot very well do that if you're dead. Again.
Good luck, Uncle. And may fair winds attend you.
As for you, Joshua, take care.
I shall do my best, Uncle.
Farewell, my nephews. When next you see me, it shall be with an army at my back. Cheerio! Oh, yeah. Do keep up, my boy!
Well, you can't have him showing us up now, can we?
We would never hear the end of it.
What have I done?
My lord.
between here and Walud. But any ship heading north has to round Zemeckis and put through the Narrow. Maintain our current bearing north-northeast, and we'll catch the Black Galleon before she vanishes again.
What's to prevent her from circling around Ash from the south?
With these winds in those waters, it'd take them forever and a fortnight to reach Stonehere.
Mid knows what she's talking about, Clive. Better than any of us lot, anyway. I say we do as she tells.
Sails on the horizon.
She's ours. Look alive, boys! Pull ahead! And keep those furnaces fed!
Aye, aye!
Do you feel that,
Jill?
All hands! Battle stations! Let's see what this girl can do.
Where one leads, so does the other follow. The bond of consciousness which joins them condemning both to the same fate. Yet my every attempt to strike it from their hearts serves only to tighten its hold. Fascinating. Then, there is naught my blade cannot sever.
Great Grigor's gash!
One of us.
Never.
I'll find her.
Bloody hell!
fight at last. We're all going to die.
Thank you. boss. Are there?
Get back!
Clive, how did you...
I'll explain later. Hands! Can you walk?
Out of here I can.
Stand still!
Phoenix. Are you not the dominant of fire? I see naught before me but a guttering flame. Can you go on?
I think so. But to where?
Joshua.
The Phoenix? Oh, I expect he will survive. This consciousness in which you coil your feeble souls is grown thick with desperation. And thus has my master turned to my blade. The world will soon be painted in black, and all that live shall gather in death's autumn wake.
Not if we remove the cause of this misery.
Not if we destroy the last of the Mother Crystals and restore balance to the world.
Come. Do you truly think it's so simple? The Blight is inevitable. Not even the Almighty might stop its endless march. Your efforts will avail us naught. Naught, that is, but suffering. You must embrace the truth, Mythos. Accept your place with the Lord.
Keep it. As long as there's a chance, there's a choice.
Ever led astray by your blind resolve.
Now, it is time you learn the inevitability of your divine fate. However much it may hurt.
Get as far away as you can.
Clive, no!
Trust me, Jill.
We don't have to do this!
Oh, but we do. If only to remind you of your duty. In the short time since our last meeting, you have grown much. Yet as a vessel, I fear my lord will still find you lacking. Come! All this fire and fury, and for what? Stopping the Blight. A foolish notion fed to you by a foolish man.
How dare you?
You know naught of this world nor of our place in it. If our fate were so easily rewritten, we would all be gods.
You down, dragging you ever further from your purpose.
And what is my purpose?
Mythos, who are we? What are the Dominants? The breath of the Creator still warm on our lips. We carry his light that we might guide the masses in his name. We are but mighty acts of God.
We are more than that.
You would be nothing without what he has granted you. The power we wield is his, and yet every time we draw upon it, it wears away at our very being. It breaks us. It unmakes us, that its immaculate aspect might reveal itself. The Icon. It is too much for even his chosen few. Apart from you, Muthos. You wield the might of many, yet your body does not answer for its avarice.
What are you saying?
What I am saying is that we dominants are a means to an end. We were created for you, that you might drink deep of our strength and thereby fulfill your divine purpose.
Which is?
To feed. As you would know, could you only look beyond the walls of your prison of self-regard. As long as you choose to ignore this, you shall never penetrate my defenses. Still, you may take solace in the fact that you are not alone in your plight. The chains of volition shackle all of mankind, but there is yet cause to rejoice. For the Lord, in his mercy, has taken pity on his flawed creations, shall see them restored to their proper forms.
And what exactly would that be?
Why, loyal servants to God.
No.
Manners, Lord Rossfield. They are men, like you and me. Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
You mean to turn everyone Akashic?
Not turn, Muthos. Turn back. For too long has mankind been led astray by their clamorous wills. It is time they return to a world of quiet equality, where they might once more know salvation.
Salvation? And abandon everything we hold dear?
We don't need your salvation. We'll save ourselves, and we'll do it on our own terms. Not yours, and not your gods.
With every defiant expression of your will, the tighter the chains of consciousness become. But perhaps that fact may be put to use.
Clive!
The faster it binds you to the remaining dominance, the stronger your hunger will become. Until it leads you back to the only answer there ever was. Mayhap not by the path my master intended, but back all the same.
Ash is not far. I could freeze a path.
You're in no fit state.
Probably not, but I can try. Don't look back!
Thank you.
hope the others are safe.
The Enterprise was clear of the gap when we fell. They made it, Jill. And they will have seen the ice where it led.
We need only wait till dawn.
This is the second time Barnabas has bested me. I'm powerless against him.
Then maybe there really is nothing else for it but to give yourself to his master. Only you won't do that. The Clive I know would never do that.
So you believe? Me. If what Barnabas said was true, then I'm more monster than man. And each time I summon the flames from within, I burn away the things that make me who I am.
Do you, though? Think of what you've used that power for. Of all the people you've saved. It doesn't matter how or by whom it was granted, only how you choose to use it. And you've chosen to use it for good, haven't you?
I've also used it to kill. What if that's my purpose? What if it's all I'm good for?
You're still that same boy I grew up with. Always so eager to save everyone around you, and yet always so alone. Because you failed to realize the one thing that needed saving most of all. You, Clive. You. You never once took the time to save yourself.
Myself. I think I might be beyond saving.
No one is beyond saving, provided they want to be saved. You fight to survive. And you survive so that you may protect those you love. It's what you do. What you've always done. And I know you're not about to change. So I'm going to help you. To give you what you need to protect us all.
those I love. And I will gladly bear your burdens too, until my last breath.
Clive.
I promise you, Jill. We will find a way to escape this fate. Find a way to save each other. That we might one day look upon the moon again, together.
And I promise you, Clive, that I will be there, no matter what you must become.
I know. I never thought a smile could bring me so much joy.
What of Barnabas? Do we pursue him?
No. Our paths will cross again soon enough, whether we like it or not. Besides, there is something we must do first.
Of course. Drake's spine. The last Mother Crystal.
The Einherjar is at the bottom of the sea. Walud won't dare move on Storm without her. But they know we're coming now. We'll need a plan. And a damn good one at that.
Then let's go home and find one. Ash will have to wait.
Mid says Odin split the sea in two. She's always been partial to a tall tale. But there's tall, and then there's tall.
I struggle to believe it myself.
I see your uncle isn't with you.
He stayed with the Enterprise.
After our brush with the Einherjar, she was in urgent need of repair. And my uncle knows a shipwright in Randalar. We're to join him there when we're ready to sail for Ash.
You sure that's wise? Last I heard, the place was still overrun with a Kashyyyk.
Show me a city where that isn't true. Ultima's plague is spreading.
We're running out of time, aren't we? We've done our best to shore up the hideaway. But I doubt a few planks will stop what's coming. Still, we'll keep at it. Every little helps, I suppose.
Let's hope so. Joshua, assuming Talia will allow it.
How are you doing? Quick look.
Seen enough?
Heard the bad news then, did you?
What bad news?
About Dravosht. Blackthorn's... Well, anyway, the mine's just down the road from there.
And the village?
Safe from the flood for now, but they've got other problems. Zoltan and the others are living on borrowed time. Dorish sent a few curse breakers to keep an eye on things, but there's only so much a couple of scouts can do. If something ain't done soon...
I won't let...
Didn't think you would.
Does Blackthorn know?
I thought it might be better if he didn't. You reckon we should tell him?
No. It's better this way.
Yeah, well, I can't stand about knowing what's happening.